Hello people, welcome here. Let's see the motion track in Sony Vegas Pro 13. Leave us comments to improve our videos. The track motion is an effect that edits the aspect of a clip in total. You don't have to confuse this with the pan crop effect. The pan crop just zooms and changes the camera focus properties, not the clip's ones. The clip is not modified. Track motion does modify the clip itself, stretching it, changing scaling or rotation. Before starting, keep in mind that the track motion affects a whole video track. So you may need to place clips in different video tracks in case you want to apply different track motion settings on each of them. Let's suppose to apply track motion to this clip. First of all, isolate it, placing it in a new video track. Then just go to the left and click on track motion. A new window appears. On the left you have the effects values and settings. On the right you have a rectangle that represents the clips of the video track interested. Use your mouse wheel to set the zoom on the rectangle. Click and drag on the rectangle to move clips in position. The central black Cartesian system will remain, representing the default settings in position and orientation. You can always double-click to centralize the rectangle as by default. Approach the corners of the rectangle, blue circles will appear. If you click and drag them, you will scale the clips on the video track. This is very important if you want to adjust video clips to get the right aspect ratio to avoid black bars on YouTube. If you want to know how to render and upload in HD, check out our video. If you hover the circumference you see, your pointer will change. If you click and drag, you will rotate the video track's clips. Remember, this affects all the clips inside the video track treated. Double-click to undo the rotation. On the left, you can give precise parameters to manage the effect properly by typing and setting values. There are some useful options more on top. The first icon enables or disables rotation. In fact, the circumference appears and disappears. The second button enables or disables snappings. Use the prevent movement buttons to move along just one direction, X, horizontally, or Y, vertically. Use prevent scaling buttons to scale along just one direction. You can also manage better the aspect ratio using lock aspect ratio to block it, or scale about center to lock the center position. However, this effect is called the track motion, since you can apply motion to the video track's clips. This simply works through the keyframes in the lower small timeline. Each keyframe saves a fixed state of the rectangle above, like its placement, its angle of rotation, and scaling. So, if you place two keyframes or rhombuses with different rectangle properties, a transition is created, where the clip passes from the first set of properties to the second one. So you will actually create motion if the position changes between the two keyframes. The more the keyframes are distant, the more the transition will last. A keyframe is created when you place the playhead in a determined instant of time and then you change the properties above. Then you can simply drag it to move it and manage it by right-clicking on it. Mind that the preview above shows you the situation where the playhead is, not the keyframe selected. You can also add some effects like glow or shadow. Simply check them on the left of the small timeline and set their properties on the left column. Then you can set its rectangle as well. Click on position again to come back setting the video track's rectangle. When you are done, just close the window. All will be applied and saved. You can apply 3D motion track as well. Before going to track motion, click on the small green icon more at the bottom and choose 3D source alpha. When you go to track motion, you will get also all 3D settings. These options work exactly in the same way seen before, with the difference that you have to be careful of which axis you are working with. Keep layout 6, which is the simpler one. You have 3 axes. X is the horizontal direction, Y the vertical direction, and Z is the height, which is equal to the zoom in or out. The front layout is exactly the 2D track motion just seen. Top and left are 2D track motions with a Cartesian system with different axes shown. Let's see an example. When you rotate using the front layout, hovering the circle, the Z letter appears. This means that you rotate respect to such axes. If you hover the circle in the top layout, the Y letter appears. So you will rotate respect to the Y axis. Check the preview. Check the blue axis while you edit the position. When you change it, always 2 axes are highlighted, so you can move respect to the XY plane, so just horizontally or vertically, or respect to the ZX plane, that means zooming or moving horizontally without moving vertically respect to the Y axis. You can check the preview or the perspective layout to see what is going on. In case you want to come back to the 2D motion track, just choose source alpha through the green icon seen before or the list appearing on the left of the layout. Remember that you are going to lose some of the properties or defects just done, as the software says. Thanks for watching this video. Check out this guide to discover more about Sony Vegas Pro 13.